मिस्टर नितिन दुबे इज साइबर सिक्योरिटी प्री सेल्स मैनेजर फॉर कैस्पर्स्की साउथ एशिया एंटरप्राइज बिजनेस. इन हिज रोल नितिन इज अकाउंटेबल फॉर द सिक्योरिटी ऑफ द ग्लोबल एंटरप्राइज पोर्टफोलियो ऑफ प्रोडक्ट्स, सर्विसेज, एप्लीकेशंस एंड कस्टमर डेटा. नितिन हैज क्लोज टू 12 इयर्स ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस इन साइबर सिक्योरिटी डोमेन विद द एक्सपोजर इन वैरायटी ऑफ इंडस्ट्रीज इंक्लूडिंग मैन्युफैक्चरिंग, फार्मास्यूटिकल्स, फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज, बैंकिंग एंड गवर्नमेंट. दिस इंक्लूड्स अ डाइवर्स बैकग्राउंड इन इंफॉर्मेशन सिक्योरिटी, एंटरप्राइज आर्किटेक्चर, साइबर सिक्योरिटी कंसल्टिंग एंड सोल्यूशन डिजाइनिंग. नितिन ट्रांसलेट्स टेक issues into layman language that is easily understandable by all business owners and provide the solution related to those issues.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I am Nitin and I am Senior Pre-Sales Manager, Kaspersky South Asia. Let me put my views on today's topic. Today, I'd like to talk about the evolving threat landscape and how Kaspersky can help you prevent against those threats. In these pandemic times, we have seen the cyber threats are increasing multifold, and the major pen pushers for that are human errors, unpatched vulnerabilities, accessible RDPs, weak passwords. When we talk about human errors, without any surprises, spam and phishing is the number one attack vector, where we have seen the significant increase, and the trend will continue in 2021. We identify that 50% of global email traffic was spam in 2020, and that's the cause of our worry. At the same point in time, attackers are more interested towards the vulnerabilities which are there in the organization. And based on the research, we identified that every third organization have around 30% of the critical vulnerabilities in their environment. And that's where they are becoming a target of attackers. At the same point in time, pandemic has pushed us to work from home. And that because we have seen the significant increase in RDP attacks in comparison to earlier times. That happens because the vulnerable or misconfigured RDP protocols, and attackers are taking the advantage for that. Ransomware, that's the fourth major attack vector. And ransomware is becoming a serious threat to all the organizations as ransomware are becoming more targeted. And there are attacker groups who are offering ransomware as a service to launch attack on different organizations or state-sponsored attacks. Keeping this in mind, we can provide you the 6 security tips to make your business safe. Keep your device and softwares up to date. Backup your data on regular basis so that in case of ransomware attack, you can utilize that particular backup and recover the data back to normal. Disable macros where they are not used. Enable advanced detection capabilities. Cultivate a secure, aware culture. Shield from phishing. Keeping all those security tips and these attacks in mind, Kaspersky has created multiple solutions. And Kaspersky has bifurcated those solutions in 3 different groups. First one is Security Foundation. Second one is Optimum Framework. Third one is Expert Framework. Each of the group is mapped to different stages in the defense against cyber attacks. When we talk about stage one, where we have categorized the broader threat landscape, we have security foundation. Organizations need to have their foundations in place to address the typical commodity threats. Otherwise, these threats just add the noise and load when dealing with more advanced threats in stage 2 and stage 3. We can use multiple Kaspersky solution in security foundation stages. As we move to stage 2, this is where the attackers and the threats become more evasive, and attackers have taken the step to go undetected. And here our optimum framework solutions come into play to help organizations to detect, identify, and respond to those undetected threats which are lurking in the environment. Finally, at stage 3, which are most targeted and advanced threats exist. These are the state-sponsored and other APT actors out there. At this stage, our expert framework solution that will help build up as well as supplement organization cybersecurity capabilities. Across all these, we have our offerings of strong support and premium services, as well as we also have managed detection and response services offering to help organizations across all the stages of the attack. In my dealing with clients across South Asia region, multiple solutions stand out as the basic need of the security environment in current scenario. Let me give you some details about those solutions. First solution, which has taken a step ahead in these pandemic times to serve the organization's security posture, is endpoint security solutions. When we talk about next-gen endpoint security solutions, we should make sure that we are not only protecting against threats, we are providing the hardening capabilities at the endpoint level, where we can define the set of applications which are allowed to run, where we can define the web control policies, where we can use the encryption, where we can identify the softwares and hardware asset inventory. On top of that, we also have the solution to detect the advanced threats, which is Kaspersky endpoint detection and response. Based on the Gartner surveys, 67% organization recommended that endpoint, next-gen endpoint security and EDR should be from the same vendor so that the solution can integrate properly, the resources can optimize, and it can work in an integrated manner. And at the same point in time, it can provide the visibility, detection, and response capabilities against advanced threats. On the second stage, we talk about the server security platform. When we talk about server security platform, we talk about hybrid cloud security solutions provided by Kaspersky. Gone are the days when your infrastructure kept nicely and securely in your own data centers, where you have full control over everything. Now, with the need for scalability and efficiency, more and more workloads are being virtualized as well as moved to the cloud. This causes a new challenge for the IT teams. They need to ensure that all their workloads are adequately protected and also have the visibility on the security posture for them. At the end of the day, regulators do not care whether your servers are in physical environment, virtual, or on a public cloud. For them, these are your servers and you need to protect them. Our hybrid cloud security has been engineered to exploit the technological advantage of hybrid cloud by dynamically following infrastructure changes and delivering powerful security with optimum speed and resource efficiency. If you are using virtualization, as you spin up more and more VMs, our solutions will continue to scale to ensure the complete data protection. It is the same for public clouds, whether your workload is sitting on AWS, Azure, or Google Cloud. As instances get spin up, protection is automatically added to those instances as well. Also, regardless whether your workloads are physical, virtual, or on public cloud, all these will be managed from Kaspersky Security Center. And it will provide you the continuous view about your data centers and servers in a single pane of glass. On top of that, Kaspersky has threat management and defense, where we can categorize this particular solution into different sections, network and endpoint. Kata, as Kaspersky anti-target attack platform, takes in metadata from email, web, and network traffic, as well as work with our endpoint detection and response client to get the endpoint telemetry. All that information fed into central node. That includes the big data and machine learning component to help analyze and detect the potential advanced threats. At the same point in time, Kaspersky's endpoint detection and response gives the expert level of capabilities to do the threat hunting in the organizations so that we can identify if there's any threat which is lurking in our environment and can play a critical role to defining the security strategy. If your organization is not ready to do the threat hunting at their own, we also have the managed services to provide the threat hunting capabilities to the organizations. At the same point in time, we do provide the retrospective analysis of the verdicts. For example, today I've detected a file, but there was nothing in that particular file at that moment. But after 3 weeks, we identified that particular file is associated to a critical threat. With the help of retrospective data, we will be able to flag that particular file again in the system so that we can protect against that. At the same point in time, this particular solution will be able to provide the verdicts to protect against advanced threats at the different stages of the attack. On top of it, Kaspersky also provides threat intelligence services. When we talk about threat intelligence, we talk about no army will go into battle without knowing more about their enemies. Similarly, no country or organization will organize their defense policies without knowing what are the threats are there for them. In the cyber world, the same holds true. You need to know who are your enemies and what all threats are there for you in the environment. That is where a threat intel component comes into the picture and provide various capabilities to identify the threats in your organization by correlating the events generated by n number of security components which are deployed in your organization. For example, one firewall is connecting to one endpoint, and that has been detected as a CNC or a bot connect communication. With the help of threat data feeds, which is a technical feed to integrate on the machine level, we'll be able to identify that this particular endpoint is being compromised. And with the help of that information, we'll be able to do the threat hunting and we'll be able to mitigate that particular threat. At the same point in time, we also include the operational intelligence over there, where we talk about threat lookup and cloud sandboxing capabilities. For example, we have detected that this endpoint has been compromised. Now, the researchers, the incident responders, wanted to analyze further on that particular threat. With the help of threat lookup and cloud sandbox, we'll be able to do that. With the help of threat lookup, we'll be able to analyze if that particular server is malicious or not, what type of activities happened with that particular server in the past with the threat lookup services. Once we identify that this particular file is malicious, right, at that point in time, we can take that particular sample and we can do the cloud sandboxing and we can analyze that particular sample on a cloud sandbox environment. From there, we'll be able to identify that if that particular file is vulnerable for our environment or not. Based on that, we'll be able to define the security posture, or we can define the policies against those kind of threats in our organization. At the same point in time, in the left top corner, we talk about the tactical threats and tactical intelligence provided by Kaspersky in the form of reporting, where we talk about APT, finance, and customer-specific threat intelligence reporting. This particular segment helps organizations to improve their threat hunting mission and to plan against the upcoming threats towards their industries, towards their geolocation. And they can also plan the roadmap protecting against those kind of APT actors who are targeting that particular industry in your geolocation. At the same point in time, with the tailored customer-specific reporting, we can identify the threat landscape for that particular organization from the external world side, where we monitor the intellectual properties of that particular customer from external one and identify what all vulnerabilities are there in their environment. If there's any targeted campaign is being planned for that customer, that particular region or that particular vertical. At the same point in time, we'll be able to do the inventory scanning so that we can identify the dark holes in their environment from external world side. And we can tell you that how attacker sees your organization from the external world. At the same point in time, digital footprinting services becomes the strategic component. When we talk about digital footprinting services, we identify what all threat actors are targeting you, or what all threat actors are targeting the geolocation where you are based in, right? With the help of these informations, we can plan our future strategies and we can protect our organizations from upcoming threats. With that, I came to an end of my session. If you have any doubts, any queries, you can reach out to us at any given point in time. We are available to connect with you, or if you want to have a deep dive on a particular session, we can connect you one-to-one offline. Thank you for today.